Hi everyone, our today's topic is decision tree algorithm. Okay, decision tree algorithm. Here we are having 15 number of steps to construct a decision tree for the given set of data, right? First of all, what is the first step? So first step is create a node n. Now here we are going to create one node n. If tuples in D are all the same class C, which means now here, first of all, D, what is D here? D is a data set, given data set, which means it may be called a training data set. So training data set is represented here by using D, right? So if the tuples of the training data set are all belongs to the same class, okay, so then what we have to do, then return node as leaf node labeled with class C. Labeled with the class C. For example, okay, see the first example. In this first example, here we have, first of all, this is the data set. This is a training data set. Okay, training data set D. This table is represent the training data set D. Okay, and this training data set has four number of attributes: roll number, subject, and subject one, subject two, then result. Okay, these are the attributes of this particular result. Is a class here, okay, target class. Okay, pass here, target class has class labels. Okay, result is a target class, and this class result has class labels of pass here. Okay, so what we have to do, this particular data, if you will observe this particular data set, this particular data set class labels are same type. Okay, class label is represented by using C. Okay, so class label 1 is pass, class label 2 is fail. Assume that class label 1 is pass and C2 is fail. So now this particular training data set has the data. Okay, all the records of this training set would be represented by using a single class label. Okay, that is pass. Single class label, that is pass. Right, how many records we have in this table? 5 number of records. Each record or 5 number of tuples. Each tuple, okay, would be represented with a single class label, pass, 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 pass. There is no second class label. Okay, right. So whenever we would have this kind of table, this kind of data sets, so then what we have to do? Okay, in this kind of situations, first of all, we need to create a, whenever we want to generate a decision tree based on some given training data set, okay, within that, the first step is creation of a node N. This is the node N, right? Have created one node, that is node N. Then if the data set, the given training data set, okay, class labels are belongs to a single class, all the class labels of that particular training set are belongs to single class, then that particular node will be a leaf node, and that would be represented by using that particular class label. Okay, that what is the class label name? Pass. So this is the leaf node. By this, we have ended this, stopped this process. Okay, whenever we will find all the class labels of the data set are same, then okay, we would return that pass as a leaf node. Okay, then we would stop the process. That is the first case, first three steps. What is the first three steps? Again, I will see enough. Create a node n. Okay. After creating a node, if tuples in D data set are all of the same class C, then return n as a leaf node labeled with the class C. Class C. The class is pass. So we have labeled with that created node as pass. Okay. Then this process is stopped. This restraint construction is completed. Okay. If not, if we would see the second case, we'll go for the second case. What is the second case? If attribute list is empty, the second case is, if attribute list is empty, then return n as leaf node labeled with the majority class in D. Majority class in D. Okay, let us check the example for these two steps. So this is the example. Example 2. Now we are in example 2. What is the statement there? If the attributes are empty, first of all, I have created one decision tree for this data set. Okay, this is the data set 2. This is data set 2. Assume this is one of the data set. By using this data set, here I have created a decision tree stepwise. Okay, what is the first attribute here I have chosen? First attribute is homeowner. Homeowner is a root node. Okay, a total I have 10 number of records within this data set. Okay, out of these 10 number of records, okay, 3 number of records are labeled with S. Homeowner is S. Okay, the home, if the homeowner is S, then under S, the class labels, S class labels are 0, no class labels are 3. So automatically it's a 0 comma 3. Whenever we will get 0 at a particular node, then that particular node is called a pure node. What is this node is called pure node, and it is represented with a and this is represented as a leaf node, right? So when it is considered as leaf node, right? So then there is no another further splittings for this node, right? Now if you'll see the homeowner is no. Okay, homeowner is with the no object. Here we are having S and no, or S and no's are remaining 7 records are there. Okay, so after that, by using the second attribute, marital status, I may go for further splitting. I would go for some further splitting. So here also married, single, divorced, different kind of values are there under marital status, right? So by using one branch as a single or divorced, another branch of marital status is married. By using this one also, I have separated okay, based on the total number of records under a marital status. Suppose if you check marital status, S number of class labels are 0, no number of class labels are 3. So here also we will get 0 comma 3. 0 comma 3 means one node is a pure, one node is represented with 0. So then this node is called pure node, right? And it is represented as a leaf node. Here we have performed again 3 and 3, six number of records is over. Remaining 4 number of records are there with us. So here we got impure node. For singular divorced, we got impure node. From that impure node, again we are going for splitting that particular node based on the annual income. Here I have taken third attribute also, annual income. So in this annual income, I have again taken two branches only. One branch is less than 80k, another branch is greater than 80k. Okay, here I have again what check the status of S class labels and no class labels. S class labels are 0, no class labels are 1. So automatically this is also considered as pure node and leaf node, right? After that, here the annual income is greater than 80k. Under this, here we have the records greater than 80k are, two records are having S class label, one record has no class label, right? So this is a impure node here. This is impure node. Then from this impure node onwards, again we are going for splitting based on a one more attribute. Do we have any other attribute left for checking? For continuing of this tree? No, we have only basically three number of attributes, four number of attributes. Among four number of attributes, the default borrower is the class. Okay, the class here we are not going, this is the final one, right? So here only we have three: homeowner, marital status, annual income. So for these three we have selected, and make these three as root node and internal nodes. But again, at the end of the annual income, for annual income, right subtree, right subchild has impure node. Whenever we'll get the impure node, then based on one attribute, again we are going to perform this kind of what, splittings, right? But here we don't have any kind of attributes to split. What we would do, what we have to do at this kind of situations, okay? Whenever you will get faced this kind of situations, the attributes are empty in data set, given data set, then better to check which class label is higher. Okay, here S class label is higher, isn't it? So then make this node as a leaf node, and the class label of this leaf node is S only. Okay, just neglect the no or remove the no. Okay, this is the, don't consider the no. Why? Because it is less compared to S class labels. S class labels are more than no class labels in this impure node, isn't it? So in this situation here, you are going to use the class label with the highest value, then that would be represented as a leaf node for this particular tree, and better to stop the process, right? Okay, like this. What is the step there? Let us go for the steps again. See the steps of fourth and fifth. If attribute list is empty, then then written N as a leaf node labeled with majority class. Majority class in D. What is the majority class there? S is the majority class, isn't it? So you should represent that one as a leaf node with S class label. Okay, if all the attributes are over or it is empty, right? These are the four and fifth steps in this decision tree. Next, otherwise, apply attribute selection method. Otherwise, apply attribute selection method for your data set. Already there is a one topic we have discussed in earlier classes, that is measures for best splitting or attribute selection criteria. Okay, we have learned about this concept by using three measures: information gain, gain ratio, Gini index. Okay, by applying any one of these measures, you can select a particular attribute among the total number of attributes in a data set. Okay, which one we want to make a root node, which one is a second internal node, third internal node. For finding, for knowing those, we are going for attribute selection methods, measures, isn't it? So in sixth steps, here you are going to apply a attribute selection method for a total data set. Why? Because our data set has multiple number of attributes, right? Okay, among those attributes, which one is a root node, which one we want to make a root node? There is no clarity. Whenever we will apply this kind of attribute selection methods based on that measurement, we come one conclusion. We may come to one conclusion, then we would select that particular attribute as a root node. Furtherly, again, at that step also, here we are going to check for some other attributes like that. Okay, now this is the sixth step. Attribute selection method to find the best splitting criterion. Okay. Label node N with splitting criterion. Okay, here you are going to use this splitting criteria method for the selection of a attribute, right? Okay, if our splitting attribute is discrete valued and multi-way split allowed, if maybe our tree is not restricted to binary tree, you may construct a decision tree as a binary tree, or you may use for multi-way splits also. It can be allowed multi-way splits also, right? Then if after choosing one particular attribute, splitting attribute, or after selecting one attribute, okay, then first of all, remove that attribute from the attribute list. Remove that attribute from the attribute list for next procedure, for further process. Okay. Then for each outcome J of splitting criteria, let DJ be the set of data tuples in dissatisfying outcome J. If DJ is empty, then attach leaf labeled with the majority class in D to node N. Else, attach the node written by generate decision tree DJ, comma attribute list. Okay, this is the process for the creation of a decision tree. We would see one example for this also. Okay. Assume now this is example three. First of all, you should make one attribute list. Okay, attribute list.
attribute list. Attribute list in the sense it may be, okay, what are the attributes we have? Homeowner one attribute, and marital status is another attribute. Third one is annual income. So these are the three attributes we have. Okay, on these three attributes, now you are going to apply, okay, measures of selection of the attribute, either information gain ratio or Gini index. Any one of the method you should apply on these three attribute to select the best attribute for splitting. Okay, after applying that, suppose my result, which means annual income, is a best attribute, then I have chosen this particular annual income is the root node among these three. Now I have created one attribute list. That attribute list has these three attributes, whichever I have in my data set. I have applied one of the measure on these three attributes. Then among these three, the annual income is a best attribute. Okay, then I am selecting this annual income as a root node. Then after selecting this one, better to remove this annual income from the attribute list. Why? Because for further process, we are in need of only homeowner and marital status only, not the annual income. That's why I have removed the this selected attribute from the attribute list. Isn't it? Finalized attribute from the attribute list. Then here, after selecting the annual income, this annual income may commit for binary split or multi-way split. But here I have used only binary split. Binary split in the sense it has only two outcomes. Right? Okay. So the first outcome is less than 80K. Second outcome is greater than or equal to 80K. If I have so now I need to find out how many number of records are there in my table, I mean in my data set, less than 80K of salary. Okay, less than 80K of annual income. For that, total number of two records are there in our table. There are two number of records are there, right? Among those two, if we check the class labels for the two records, yes, S class labels are 0 are there, no class labels are 2 are there. Okay, those two records are, okay, assigned with no class label only. Then this particular node is called 0, 2, right? 0, S number of class labels, 2, no number of class labels. Okay, whenever the node got that 0, then this particular node is called a pure node. Okay, automatically this node is represented with a leaf node, isn't it? This node is represented as leaf node, right? And coming to the second branch of the annual income, that is greater than or equal to 80K. Among this greater than or equal to 80K, here we found 8 number of records are there. How many number of records are total? I have 10 number of tuples or 10 number of records. Already 2 number of records are classified, okay, from left child. Remaining 8 number of records are under the right child. Okay, out of 8 number of records, 2 number of records are class 2 number of records are labeled with S class label, 6 number of records are labeled with no class label. So this is a impure node, right? This is one of the impure node, 2, 6. So whenever we would get this impure node, then we should go for taking the another attribute for splitting, okay, for judging the process, or otherwise you may say to construct a tree. So at this place, at this impure node place, I have taken some other attribute, that is homeowner. Next I have chosen the attribute is homeowner. Now I am removing the homeowner from the attribute list itself. After choosing the homeowner is a second internal node. This can be represented, this can be used at the place of impure node, at the place of impure node, right? So now I have used this homeowner at this place. Now how many number of records are there with us? 8 number of records. So for this 8 number of records, now we are going to do the process of same process. I mean, same from 6th number to 15th number, the algorithm would be repeated. What it is, after selecting a particular attribute, okay, for splitting criteria, then remove that particular attribute from the attribute list. Okay, after removing that, then you need to process the homeowner. It may have either 2 or 3 number of branches. Each branch you should represent it with J. Okay, here also this is J, less than 80k is there na, you can call it as J1. What it is? Less than 80k is J1 equal to less than 80k, and this branch is J2. Greater than 80k branch is, we would represent by using J2. If you have more number of branches, J3, J4, J5, like that. Here also, this is J1, this is J2, and if you have third one also, it is J3. Third branch also, this is J3. Right? Like this, each and every outcome of a splitting attribute, okay, is represented with J1 or DJ. DJ1, DJ2, DJ3, like that. The process is again going to same. So whether how many number of S class labels are there, how many number of no class labels are there under each J1, J2, J3, these are the values of a homeowner. Here also J1 is a value of less than or 80k, one of the value of annual income. Greater than or 80k is a one of the value of annual income. Here also homeowner, yes, no, maybe. You may take 3 conditions, means those 3 would be represented as J1, J2, J3. Yes, no, maybe. Okay, like that. Right? So this process is repeated. If suppose any one of these branches, okay, any one of the these branches are empty, then what we have to do? Empty, then that particular node is called a leaf node. If we may get pure node, if we will get the pure values at that particular node, that is also represented as leaf node. If at one particular J1 doesn't have any kind of values, empty also, you may represent that particular node as empty node. Next, you may go for splitting the further, either J2 or J3 for further process. Again, if you will get impure nodes, if you will get pure nodes, no problem. If you will get impure nodes, again, go for taking other third attribute, that is marital status, and marital status, make the marital status as the internal node at a pure node place, then the process will be repeated same. Okay, this is the decision tree algorithm. again we would see the steps of this algorithm from sixth step onwards. First one, what is the sixth step? Apply the attribute selection method to find the best splitting criterion. Okay, criterion. And if the node is selected for split, best split, I mean if the node n is selected, which means attribute is selected, then that attribute may be a discrete valued or multi-ways. That attribute can be either multi-way split with discrete values attribute. Then here we are going to remove that particular attribute from the attribute list. Okay, for each outcome j, the outcomes of a attribute would be represented with the j, right? For each outcome j of splitting criterion, let dz is the set of data tuples in d satisfy outcome j. If dz is empty, then if dz is one of the j1 or j2 is empty, then attach a leaf labeled with a majority class in d to node n. Else attach the node written by generate decision tree dz comma attribute list, dz comma attribute list. Again we have started from sixth step onwards. Okay, finally return n. These are the steps under a decision tree algorithm. Okay, thank you.